Hi, my name is Farah Sheikh, and I'm a professor in the Department of Medicine at the University of California, San Diego. I'm excited to share with you recent findings on an article that we recently published in the Journal of Clinical Investigation entitled Desmosomal COP9 Regulates Proteome Degradation in Arrhythmogenic Right Ventricular Dysplasia / Cardiomyopathy, which I will call ARVC for short. I'd like to acknowledge the first author, Yan Liang, a postdoc fellow in my lab who was instrumental in uncovering the major findings of the study. Our work is focused on ARVC. This is a complex and fatal genetic cardiac disease, historically defined as a right heart disease, but recent studies identify left or biventricular involvement. Based on its name, it's not surprising that electrical defects or arrhythmias drive the disease, which can be made worse with exercise and been shown to lead to sudden death in young individuals. However, there's a structural component, as ARVC patients also exhibit cardiac muscle cell loss, replacement fibrosis, and fat deposition. To date, there are no treatments for ARVC and limited mechanistic insights on drivers of the disease. What we do know is that human genetic studies suggest that it is a disease of the desmosome. If you zoom in from the heart and focus on the cardiac muscle cell-cell junction, you can identify three major structures. Desmosomes are electron-dense structures that are mechanical anchors that essentially prevent the heart muscle cells from ripping apart at high mechanical insults. The desmosomal complex consists of five classic major proteins, shown here, and desmosomal gene mutations account for 40 to 50% of ARVC cases. Desmoplaquen was one of the first to be linked to ARVC and shown to harbor left dominant and biventricular forms of ARVC. To better understand mechanisms driving ARVC, we performed a yeast-2 hybrid screen to uncover new protein targets regulating human desmosomal biology and disease using desmoplaquen as a bait. We identified CSN6 as a new cardiac desmoplaquen interacting protein. CSN6 is part of a multi-protein complex consisting of 8 subunits, with CSN6 being at the core and the 6th subunit. The role of CSN6 in the heart has not been established, but multiple studies highlight that CSNs can control protein degradation. As a result, we hypothesize that CSN6 is a new component of the cardiac desmosome that regulates desmosomal protein degradation with important implications in ARVC, a disease of desmosomal protein breakdown. We validated the interaction using the N-terminus region of desmoplaquen to show that it had strong interactions with CSN6. Using crystal structure data, we showed that CSN6 can structurally complex with the N-terminus region of desmoplaquen. Using co-immunoprecipitation assays, we showed that CSN6 can pull down desmoplaquen and its interactor, plakophilin-2, in adult mouse heart extracts. And finally, using cardiac-specific desmoplaquen-deficient mice, we showed that CSN6 is enriched and colocalizes with desmoplaquen at the cell-cell junction, and with desmoplaquen loss, there is a significant reduction in CSN6 at the cell-cell junction, altogether highlighting CSN6 as an integral component of the cardiac desmosome. We showed using cardiac-specific inducible CSN6 knockout mice that at early stages, CSN6 loss resulted in desmoplaquen loss, as well as connexin 43 loss, which is an early target of desmoplaquen loss. At late stages, we can show that the whole desmosomal protein complex is falling apart based on the loss of protein levels alongside connexin 43 loss. However, proteins in other subcompartments of the cardiac muscle are not impacted, suggesting that CSN6 loss accelerates desmosomal protein complex destruction. Since CSN6 is an enzyme which targets denatalization of colons and essentially prevents proteins from being tagged for degradation, we hypothesized that CSN6 loss would have opposite effects and rev up these pathways. Here we show that colon 1 and colon 3 are hypernetylated in CSN6 deficient hearts, and the whole netylation profile is impacted in CSN6 deficient hearts, which then translates to hyperubiquitination and also an increase in selective autophagy pathways as evidenced by increased P62 levels. At the ultrastructural level, CSN6 loss exposes the cardiac desmosome to destruction. And you can, this is evidenced by the hyperaccumulation of autophagic vesicles and multi-membrane structures alongside these destroyed desmosomal structures. By exploiting cardiomyocytes from CSN6 flox mice, we show that with the addition of Cre, we see similar effects of CSN6 loss, such as the hypernetylation, as well as the hyperubiquitination. Using cyclohexamide assays, we show that essentially, unlike LAC-Z controls, where desmosomal proteins degradation is relatively unchanged over time because of its long half-life, that with CSN6 loss, now you see this accelerated desmosomal protein degradation over the same time frame. At the level of disease, we show that in desmoplaquin deficient hearts, that we see the same signatures. Again, this hypernetylation, hyperubiquitination, and the ultrastructural evidence of hyperaccumulation of these protein degradation machinery at the cell-cell junction, highlighting that disruption of the CSN6 desmosomal complex and protein degradation underlies ARVC in mice. In collaboration with investigators at UCSF, we identified an ARVC patient that carried desmosomal mutation, and one was in a highly conserved amino acid in the N-terminus region of desmoplaquin, which is a region where CSN6 interacts. And what we showed through in silico modeling is that this mutation was destabilizing. And so we predicted that this would interrupt or abrogate CSN6 interactions. We proved this in yeast 2 hybrid studies, where you can see now that the mutation results in abrogation and binding to CSN6. And also through using human cardiac tissue from this patient, we saw loss of CSN6 or reduced junctional localization of CSN6 in this patient's heart. Furthermore, we showed using 2 cardiac-specific CSN6 knockout mice that CSN6 loss is sufficient to trigger sudden death, as you can see from the Kaplan-Meier survival curve. And also classic gross morphological features such as this biventricular dilatation, fibrosis in the right and the left side of the heart, as well as this lipid deposition that you see in the hearts of these mice, including this biventricular dysfunction that we're able to image through magnetic resonance imaging studies. And at early stages, we also saw these classic features of these arrhythmias and the ventricular depolarization delay that's classic to ARVC in these mice, highlighting that CSN6 loss is sufficient to drive all of the classic disease features of ARVC in vivo. To determine whether human desmosomal mutations destabilize CSN6 interactions and are a trigger to ARVC, we generated double heterozygous mice which harbored desmoplaquin and plakophilin 2 mutation that was found in our ARVC patient. We showed that this mutation abrogates the binding of desmoplaquin to CSN6 and that this leads to significant reduction in CSN6 levels, as well as this loss of desmosomal proteins, including connexin 43 loss. And again, this hypernetylation profile. And this was sufficient to drive ARVC features such as RV dilatation, arrhythmias, ventricular depolarization delay, cardiac enlargement, and depressed cardiac function in aged mice. So in summary, we identify a novel desmosomal substrate recognition and protein turnover system imprinted within the cell junction of the heart, and that CSN6 essentially restricts protein degradation at the desmosome to prevent cardiac disease and sort of maintain desmosomal proteome homeostasis within a healthy range. However, with desmosomal mutations and loss, now you abrogate or destabilize the CSN6 interactions. And as a result, this triggers desmosomal protein loss and ARVC pathogenesis. With that, I'd like to thank past and present members of my laboratory alongside key collaborators at UCSD and outside of UCSD who have been instrumental to the work. I'd also like to thank our funding agencies for supporting our work. Thank you.